think if you get the best roast potatoes on the table, then it's going to be a fair chance of being one of the best Christmas dinners ever. So, parboiled potatoes over here. I've got Maris Pipers, right? And they've had about 10 to 12 minutes parboiling. Drain them and put them in a colander to steam. This kind of steaming part is deeply important, okay? Because it's dehydrating. It's creating a lovely, dry, fluffy surface. And then we want to chuff up. Get your little colander and just toss it around like that. It looks bashed up and beaten up. That's going to be the crispiest, beautifulest potato with a fluffy inside. Now, you can use any fat you like, goose fat, you know, turkey fat from the roast. I've got butter, olive oil. It's a nice, sweet, delicious fat. We're going to go in there just like that. A little season of sea salt, some black pepper, very, very simple flavorings. Go for some cloves of garlic and give them a good spank. Gorgeous. Cracked garlic, beautiful. So just kind of toss the potatoes in the fat, almost like dressing a salad. Then we're going to roast them off for about 40 minutes at 180. Then they're going to look like this. But this is still not perfect. I've got a little trick. Get a masher or something flat and just squash these potatoes. And it kind of busts the side. It lets that fluffy part billow out. And it gives you a crispier crunch to your potato. It makes an amazing difference. And last but not least, get some rosemary. Just put it in a little oil like this in my hand. And just move it around and then sprinkle that on top of the potatoes. If you haven't got rosemary, then any woody herb will work beautifully. Then put it back in the oven at 180 degrees for a further 20 minutes to crispen up. And they're gonna look like this, which is a beautiful, sizzling, gorgeous roast potato. And the whole point of this, of course, is that we create that wonderful crispy outside and that fluffy, gorgeous, delicate inside. And the contrast of that with the garlic, the oil, the crunchy rosemary is literally phenomenal.